network automation using Python and Cisco.
So today we're going to be looking at how to actually create a Jinja template from scratch based on a real life example using this very, very old Cisco router. So the reason I'm using this is because it's small, silent, and it fits on my desk. I have got some layer 3 switches, but they're a bit too noisy for this video. So what we've got is an empty Jinja template. We've got my CSV with a router name, an IP address for interface for the VLAN 10, and some IP address and subnet for VLAN 20. First thing first is to let's go on to my Linux box, and what we're going to do is we are going to Telnet to the Cisco router, which is 192.168.1.87. Password is Cisco. Right, so I've actually already tested this, and what I need to do is change the host name back. So password conft host name, what was it? It was 877. That'll do. Oh yeah, let's call it R877. There we go. So and then what should we do? Let's just do show run. And where I've tested this, I've put in some VLAN information. So what I will do is remove VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. Oh yeah, I didn't. Right. Conft no int VLAN 10. Not all config may be removed and may reappear after reactivating the logical sub interfaces. Yeah, that's fine. I just want to clear this so that I can get a base config to show you. Good. So VLAN. Yeah, so in the config, VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 have disappeared, which is what I want. So let's just copy all this. And let's go up as far as here. Copy. And then in our Jinja template, we paste in the Cisco router config. And then what we next do is we then remove that, and we put double quotes, and then we say host. I'm going to call it host underscore name. You can call it whatever you want. So host underscore name, and then in my code, hopefully I've got it ready. Host underscore name. Yep. And then I also need to do, I need to create VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. So what I will do is I'll put a placeholder in, and I will call it, in actual fact, it's not just the IP, it's the whole shooting match. So VLAN 10, VLAN 20. So VLAN 10 I will put in, I'll put another exclamation mark. Exclamation mark is a bit like a hash in Python. And then I'll do the same for VLAN 20. And make sure I save it. So I've got a Jinja template with host name, VLAN 10, VLAN 20. VLAN 10, VLAN 20, and host name. So 1, 2, 3. those are the three placeholders that appear in the Jinja template. And next, I need to just make sure that I've changed my... Yeah, so what I need to do is I need to put IP address 10.2.2.2 and then also 255. I need to put subnet mask as well. Okay, and I'm going to change it to what it from what it was before, just so that so there's no skullduggery, no cheating going on. And right, so I can run this from, let's just bring up the terminal, bring this on top. And what I will do is I will generate the code, or generate the config, so I'll run that from here. Code is already running. Ah, have I got it running in? Right, let's just run it from here instead then. So let's run Python conf builder.py. And it's, if you're watching really quickly, it's just generated router _rng.txt. And it's put in router rng there into the host name. So what we're looking at here is just my text file. Ah, it's left out the VLAN name. We need to fix that. So, fact, what we need to do is put in, we'll put in some more columns in the CSV, so we'll say VLAN 20. So now effectively we've got five columns in the CSV. So if we look at it, if we look at the CSV in, there we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we go. So what I need to do now is actually put in some more placeholders. So let's close that txt file and actually delete it. And then we need to change our Jinja template. So what we'll do here is instead of what we had before, we just need to put in let's just call it int 10, and then I will call that one int 20. So then int 10 and int 20 will pick up interface VLAN 10, interface VLAN 20. So it all become clear very shortly. So let's just go and double check that in 10, 20. And then from the Python file, we just need to add in, so we need to copy those two, paste those in there. And now those have moved along, so they will be now be three, four. And CSV int 10, CSV int 20. There we go. And then I just need to add those in here as well. So we'll just copy those. In fact, I don't really want to be copying too much because it's messy. Equals int int 10 equals CSV int 10. And do the same there. So int 20 equals CSV int 20. And I think that's correct. So what we've done is we've installed placeholders for the interface name, or the, let me show you. So on the config, we want, so we want well, we've got interface VLAN 10, we'll have interface VLAN 20 and interface VLAN 10. And then below we'll have the individual IP address for them. So I think that's ready to run. So we've got, that's the wrong bit, I think. What is it? Let's just go back. So we should have five placeholders altogether. Yeah, interface VLAN 1 we don't want to change, definitely not, because that's what we're connected on VLAN 1. So VLAN 10, VLAN 20, and that's the IP address for VLAN 10, and that's the IP address and subnet for VLAN 20. So yeah, close that, move that down here, and let's run it again. We should get a text file. Yeah, good. And then router OMG, and down here, interface VLAN 10, IP address, interface VLAN 20, IP address. Got space there. I don't know if that's going to break it or not. Shouldn't do. Just going to fix it anyway. Move to trash. And I've got space there, so get rid of that space. If it was in an Excel file, it would, you would visually see it. It was there, and tidy that up anyway. So yeah, I've not got spaces there, so those four are okay. And let's just run conf builder again. Let's run it here. There we go, text file. And this time, space is gone. And if I do this, T, and then I'm just going to copy all of this, right click copy, right click paste, and boom. So now it's changed from 877 back to router underscore RNG. And then if we do show IP int brief, you will see that we now have VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 as per our CSV, well, our one line CSV. But obviously this shows you the power that you could have many, many files, and then you could update many, many appliances, devices, switches, routers, whatever. And yeah, there we go. So just one more little thing that I'll show you while we're here, and that is, yeah, close this. I'll just quickly show you another script, which is, obviously Telnet is pretty archaic these days. All we're gonna do is we're gonna show you, I've closed it. Yeah, so what we'll do is we'll remotely, or with a script, we'll just log in using pexpect. We'll log in using our IP and our username, our password, and then we will just get some output into a text file. Yeah, but it won't be pretty, but it will just, it could be used to verify that the changes have taken place, because what you could then do is just compare your text file after with your text file that you had before. Let's go. So if we do Python tel cisco.py, so this will log in, enter your right account, Cisco, wait a second or two. Uh, and that's taking too long. Why is that? Let's just investigate what's going on here. Telnet 1.87. Ah. Oh, what was going on there? Timeout exceeded. Blah, blah. Telnet plus host. Oh, I've changed the, I put in the name of the router there, so what is it now? It's changed, hasn't it? Router underscore RNG. Yeah. That goes in there, and that's the router host name goes in on that line. And so what we're doing is we're telling it the password and the router name, and then it should hopefully return us some output. There we go, and it's run. Obviously you can't see anything happen there, but it will go output, and B for bytes, show IP interface brief, and then we've got interface IP address, and there we see, so in here we have, it's not pretty, but we do actually have all of our VLAN information and our interface information, which is what we've modified with our script. So yeah, I can't show you SSH right now in this video because this old piece of hardware is too old to support SSH, but I just thought I'd show you that with Telnet. And what we're using is pexpect. So you send a command and then it's expecting a certain response, and that before it carries on and so on. So yeah, there we go. And we've now got a router with VLAN 1, which is what we're connected to. And we've also got, what is going on here? I think there's some kind of sticky key thing on Linux, is there? I don't know. Anyway, yeah, VLAN 20, and that's what we gave it from the CSV. And we've got VLAN 10, which is what we also gave it from the CSV. So, there we go. Thank you for watching, and I'll be back next time. I may resurrect some actual proper hardware that uses SSH. The concept is the same, really. So yeah. Till next time, thank you for...